we do have a Mark Toastmaster in us.
Can you name the Indian shooting ace who recently attained the world number one position in the women's 10 meter air rifle? It's Apurvi Chandela. See, I got my answer. Had the question been about the Virat Kohli's new record, you all must have been hooting by now. A very warm good afternoon to all my dear Toastmasters and guests. Yeah. All of us face challenges, but how many of us don't give up and use those challenges to our advantage? Those who do become an inspiration for all of us, like my cousin sister for me. In a male-dominated society, one of my sisters wanted to pursue her dream and reach at a big post in a famous company. But as we know, women have many barriers in this society. So my sister also had a lot of them. Women are quite capable of being just as successful as men when given the chance outside of the house. She struggled a lot to break the stereotype of her family and fulfill her dream to reach at a big post in a famous company. She came out from her comfort zone firstly and went to Kolkata and worked very hard. But her family didn't support her because my uncle wanted to marry her with a suitable boy. But yes, a good time came. Can you guys guess where she is and what is she doing now? I'm asking you. She is currently in the marketing head of Google in Singapore. How many girls reach there around us in a male-dominated society? Even today, women are better off today, but still far from being equal with men. According to a July report 2019, participation of females in the labor force in India in 2005 was 36.7%. But this rate has fallen to 26% in 2018. There are many reasons which become barriers for women. The biggest challenge is dropout of girls from schools, which is propelled by multiple social circumstances like early marriage, poverty, lack of safety in schools, lower expectations of girls' education, and traditional gender norms. On International Women's Day 2019, World Bank estimates so that in low-income countries like India, less than 2/3 girls complete their secondary schools, and only 1 in 3 complete their primary education. Above all, it is digital divide, or better known as gender digital divide, prevents or limits women's access to, use of, and benefit from information and communication technology, which limits them from gaining employable skill sets and entering into the workforce. Raising women's participation in the labor force at the same level as men can boost India's GDP by 27%. IMF Chief Christine Lagarde and Norway's Prime Minister Erna Solberg have said in a joint paper, women would account for 21% of the overall participation at the meeting to be attended by over 3,000 world leaders, including politics, business, arts, etc. Raising women's labor force participation to that of men can boost GDP. For example, as much by 9% in Japan and 27% in India. There are many benefits of the working women. Studies reveal that women tend to be great multitaskers because they also plan their work to be more efficient. Reports are also showing that more women than men are on social media. This is because women tend to focus on creating community. Reducing gender gaps in employment as well as in education can help economies diversify their exports, thereby supporting greater bank stability and financial sector resilience. It is a universal mission, a task from which every country would benefit. According to them, today before I leave, I want you all to silently pledge that you will stop stereotyping the word success only with men. Be cognizant of the fact that this world is a living space for all the genders. And nobody holds an invisible power to suppress the other gender. And especially when it is a battle between the sexes, between men and women. The lady at your home is your mother, sister and wife. And when she steps out, she is your counterpart, who is equally hardworking, smart and resilient. Women like Apurvi Chandela, Susmita Sen, Arundhati Bhattacharya, and our first full-time lady finance minister, Nirmala Sitharaman, are faces to million women sitting at home who have talent and potential, but unfortunately can't work. It is a time to forget the hue and cry for cricket mania and other male-dominated professions, but inclusive to a woman-oriented society. Over to you.